Hello, guys. Welcome back. Today's show. Let me put it more. Okay. Today we are going to start. Continue to build the color modulation on my T-34. Okay. So. The last time I'm using, I want to show you these colors, okay? This is the 4BO modulation from Mick Jimenez. They got these four ones, but the range is more wide. They put... I'm sorry about my compressor. It's very loud, okay? They have the other of these. It's the Russian Shine. And below, they have of the Russian Dark Bass. They have the Shadow, okay? So I am using now these four colors. And I will show if I want more, a thing more dark or more, more in more highlights. I go with the matte white or the matte black. Okay, so I'm going to use this airbrush. This I am waiting for some pieces for my evolution. And so Obis Guinea sent me this airbrush to continue my work, and I will go. And I stop in the parts of the dark colors. I am going now to make the dark of this tank. Okay, so I load my airbrush with a color. I put the, let me show you this one, the Russian Dark Bass, and let me dark a little more. Okay, here on the side too. And I think you can see. This is a very dark color, okay? If you want to know, I am using a 02 needle, okay? It's that why it's more complicated to see this dark so bad, but I need this 02, okay, because I'm going to make some spots with the bright spots, okay? So let me clean here the airbrush. And let me put a little of my airbrush cleaner, just one drops. Okie dokie. I'm going to show you one thing when you are working with some lights. When I will go with the Russian eye light, I'm going to show one of the tricks I made. Okay, so the darks are all, it's like I made a press shade on this, okay? So now I'm going to use, let me put this here, I'm going to use now the Russian light base. I'm going to highlight some of the panels, okay? Like here, 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 okay? So let me show. Uh, And another thing, if I today I'm not respond to you, to your comments, it's normal because I have the monitor on my back, and in these steps I want to be concentrate. Okay, so don't be mad with me, but I think you understand what I say. So now I'm going to put 5 drops of this and a little of 1 drop of my flow improver. Okay, you want to make something of this ammo. Okay, it helps a lot this to flow. Even your paint, it's really nice as leaving the airbrush, but it's a nice thing. Okay, so now let's begin, and I'm going to show you right away. I'm going to use a bottle cap. Okay, and let me show you a little F brush cleaner. Okay, some drops there. Okay, and a little water. Okay, if this here you point this there and you are going to clean, I'm going to remove this first one. Okay, I'm going to put this in. I don't want to lose it. And what it's good for this, it's to clean the point of the needle. Okay, when I need it, I have this here. Okay, so let's begin working on the panels. As you can see, because this is a 0.02 needle, I want more spreading wide. I put the cap again, and you can clean the same way you put there. Okay, you blow a little, then, and you're ready to go. Okay. Take a little patience for this, okay? This is the time you can correct. Okay. I think you can see it. Okay, so it's time to pass my curtain. So if you make like this, normally you can push out. The box. This compartment here too. Here on this, some parts, I don't want this is going to be okay, all in shadow area. I think you can see it good. You see the different colors for the inside, okay? So now here, just a little. Here on the fender, it's a good way to correct your press shade. So up your tool. Okay, nicely done. So now it's time to grab some type of card or like that. I'm going to use this. I'm going to cut for have good edges to use to paint. Hello Kim, I'm sorry, but like I said before, I am on backwards to my monitor and I don't see the monitor. Okay, so now it's time to begin with this or the visit card, something like that. And let's go and mask some thing like this too. Like some color modulation, okay? Okay, done. Now let's begin here of this side. Begin always on your car, and then you go. Done. Do not go too much because we want to have some colors on this. Okay. I think on top of here it's done. Now let's go and begin with the turret, okay? So, sorry about the compressor, guys. Going to begin with the gun barrel. Just a white one. And I kept just five here on the middle, a little more this color. You see it? Let's blend a little together. Okay. And here too. If you see, you must go again with the black, a dark base. Don't have any problem with that. Okay. So now I'm going to change for the brightest color. This is all jumbled today. Okay, just a little clean on my airbrush. Water. Okay, now it's time to go with the Russian highlight, okay? And this step, don't go too crazy. I will show you why. So now it's time to remove the airbrush cap. Okay, I must have one new of these. Okay. Now it's time to go with the real color, okay? The highlight. Okay, just a little there. A little. Here. Okay, let me put here. Okay. Here. And here too. Okay. Just a little. Here we can put some. And here too. Okay. don't have any problem in this part because we are going to put filters and it makes lots of difference, okay? Can see I am not using the cards now. Okay. And I am done now with this. Now it's time to go here. Okay, so the same thing we do with the Russian green base. Now we are going to accent and put more lights on this, okay? So let me put here again the cap. I'm going to begin here. This fender. Begin in the middle, okay, to begin to make like this, and about 15 centimeters of your model, okay. Now here. Then here a little. And you can see I'm not using that very expensive brushes. Some there's some light on this side too. Not put much. Okay. Now here. This is a full box, just like that. All that rivets I'm going with a brush, okay? So now here, begin in the middle. Making beside the color modulation, you are doing a fade effect on the panels. Okay, as you can see, I'm going some here. Not too much. I'm making a Russian tank and we are listening to the United States. Okay. Now, here on the side, let's build this. So, sorry, I'm going to flip this. Now I can go. Let me see. One other thing, don't do on these things was the pressure, like 1.2, because you don't want a very high pressure on this, because the high pressure make your paint to start drying on the point of your needle. Okay, and it's not good. Let me put here. Okay. Don't worry. As you can see, it's not good on the point. Let me remove. Now I'm doing some things with free hands. You got this spot, it's not easy. There's nothing we can do, my friends. The card, this card, it's good because it limits your workspace, and then you go make
piece in a different way.
Okay.
Okay. Almost done here. Okay. Not here. A little more. See? This is no problem. I got with, I go back with more so color. Let me go there for it to spread a little. Okay, done. Just a little more in here. Boxes and you are seeing, you are thinking, this is very bright. No, it's not very bright, guys. It's going to be more dark, okay? And the color modulation is this. We want dark and very bright, okay? A little more on this side too. Okay. Almost done. This, what I do, it's make a contrast, okay? There are some areas they are more, have more light, okay? So I choose this one. It's like the sun going down for this, so I use this to make that difference, okay? The shining, and you all see, okay? We got more light on this. Let's see here too. And yes. Like this. And you don't put too much because the sun is going down on this way and this is more bright, okay? And this side, it's more dark, so you can put here. Some more light there, and here a little mist, okay? And on this, we are done. Now, let's go and grab. Because I choose the sun on this side, I must do the same thing here. Okay.
finger on the top. And this is going to be like this, okay? A little like this, okay? Because the gun barrel don't touch that, so like this, let me see. Okay, the sun like this, just a little more here. And here on catch too. Okay. Done with this part of the color modulation, okay? So now let me put this aside. Okay. It's very important you, when you put your model and making these color modulations, imagine all. It's like a landscape on the canvas. Imagine the light. Even is in the night theme, you see the lights, the moonlight and everything, and you choose always a direction, and that's one of the things will make a difference on your model, believe, okay? So now let's go to this part. The wheels are all primer, and I'm going to make a very fast modulation on the wheels. It's very easy to make this modulation, so let me cleaning this. So grab the dark base, the most dark you got there. These wheels are all green, they are not have that rubber on the sides, so it's going to be all green, okay? Putting a little flow improver, and now I'm going to use the thinner, okay? And let me mix this. It's very important when you put the thinner to mix well, okay? Let me begin and paint this. If that dark green, okay, the side of the wheels too. And I think you can see I'm working with a 0-2 needle. As you can see, no troubles, done.
remove the front cap, clean it. That's the best way. So now you can grab an air dryer. I got this one. This is a travel air dryer. Sorry. Let me put again this and use it. It's very good to make your accelerate the process. Okay. I want to show it's very easy. And you can see with 10 drops of this, 5 drops of this, and 1 of this, I paint all these ones. I paint this in gray because the green, it's going to be better on the grays, okay? It's my point of view. If you paint in black, normally the green is going to be very more dark, okay? Okay, now it's good. Indeed, ready for the next step. The next step, I'm going to use a little light base, okay? And I'm going to construct the color modulation from the inside to outside, okay? We are not going to need too much of this. I'm not putting here now nothing of my thinner, only 1 drop of the flow improver, okay, and from the inside with a circular motion, okay, just a little bit of this, okay. Can go here, I'm showing you. Don't forget, a circular motion, okay? We want the dark in the side of the rim. Most light. Some these are giving a struggle, so not any trouble. As you can see, I got just with this a little color modulation. And when we are going with the brightest, you will see the difference. More careful. Okay. Let's go a second time. And I, like I said, always, this is your model, you make, and you paint like you want, okay? There are some bastards out there. They are always putting problems on the work of some guys.
So as you can see, then, well, let's remove the rest of the paint. And now, we put the Russian light base, and we are going now with the Russian eye light, okay? Now it's just a little, okay? Now be more careful, okay? Just that center, okay. The way I do it's because I am using filters for this, okay? Oil filters. You can use washes, acrylic washes too, but I like to use oils, okay? The filters are going to unify all these contrast colors, okay? And one thing, if you're using this Russian eye light, it's one color. If you must need to drop a little your pressure on the compressor, okay? Because this dry very quickly on the tip, okay? Some water and some airbrush cleaner, and we are done with this. Now, and let me tell you, every color modulation, it's a new thing on each model, okay? I have the next one of the next I'm going to make the color modulation. It's the Russian T-54, okay? And it's very different to make the color modulation because the turret, it's round, it's not with flat things. I show you. Here, it's very different, the color modulation on this, okay? Here it's easy on the fenders, on these panels, it's easier. But the turret, it's very different. Here you got F lit, it's very different of this, okay? But I will show you this on Monday, the color modulation on this, and you will see how I do on this. Tomorrow I will make the color modulation, desert color modulation on the M2 Bradley, okay? From the M2M build group. And we are almost done on this. The things now I'm going to do, I will show you. It's using these colors, it's not meaning the 4BO color modulation for Russians. It's not, it not seems to be the correct color for the vehicle, okay? And for this T-34, I'm going to need the specific color of this, okay? You see it, the color modulation, it's very beautiful, okay? But there are one thing I must put on the top of this before I put the oil filters on this. It's the real color for this, and let me bring that and show you. Okay, some of you guys think I am sponsored by Mick Jimenez, but I am not. I like very much of Mick Jimenez, and I buy lots of products of him. So for this, they release this one. This is the mythical Russian greens. Okay, this is from 1935 to 2016, and they have the right colors, the greens. Okay, so my advice, it's my way to do. It's not in your mind, it can't be the right way, but for me, it's the way I do it. And so I make all the modulation color, and then I will go, okay, with one of these colors, and it's going to be this one for this T-34. It's going to be this one, and let me show you. If I have here, yes, I have here on the. If you see on my videos, you can see the colors I put on this. And for my T-34, I'm going to need the 19, okay? This is going to be the color, okay? It's not a big difference on the color modulation, okay? But I'm going to put this like you make the buff, when you put the buff color on your models to make that dust thing, you make with this color. I'm going to use this and this too. This is a transpirator from me. What is this? This is the base of all the paints of Mick Jimenez, okay? And what I do with this, I use a mix of 75% of this and only 25% of the main color, okay? Because I want this to be very transparent and leave the pigments of the nearest color of reality of this, and not going to put a big coat of paint, okay? So if you need to make two or three passes of this, go, no problem. But normally I'm going to do, I'm going to put 10 drops of this and 9 drops, and I put 3 drops of the colors. I do on my model like that dust effect you do with your Tamiya buff or a Vallejo buff, and do the same thing with the model. The color, the right color, is going to be in the model, okay? And then when you're using the filters for this, it's going to be very, very nice, okay? So now it's time to paint some things, okay, with the brush. Sorry, let me put here. I'm going to retch, no, this will not. I'm going to use this 00 from Umbral, okay? And let this begin to curl. Okay, yes, I am seeing now what you wrote. You got all the reason on that. The 4BO, it's much darker on the after 1955, and that's why they release this one. I will show. There is inside here a paper. And let me show. They give you this chart, okay? And you are all right. Here from 1941 to 45, you can see the difference, okay, on this chart. And then the 60s to the 80s, it's always one of the colors, okay? But I'm going to use the dust, like a dust effect with this main color, okay? And then when I put the filters, it's going to be very much darker, okay? So now what I'm going to use, I'm going to use the lightest color, the Russian highlight. Yes. So now I'm going to put here one drop of this color. Okay. And I'm going to put here, I'm going to make a 15% of this. And now with a drop of white, and to unify all that color, I'm going to put one drop of this transpirator. Okay, you see there? It's very, very transparent. So, with the brush, let's mix this. And as you can see, it's more bright. And when I am doing this, I have here one thing. I don't know if you know. This is a retarder. I like a lot of this from Createx. One drop of this only. And we'll go to retard your paint to dry and give you at least half an hour of this mix to work, okay? And you can put this on your airbrush too, okay? And why I use this Createx, okay, because it's go with all the colors of MIG, Vallejo, Tamiya, everything, okay? I don't have sure, but it's like an oil, okay? So now I'm making the point, and I am going now and paint some of the rivets, okay? And as you can see, we need more light, so let's go and put one drop of white. I want contrast on this. So let me see now. I think it's going to be okay. You see it now. This is going to make very good difference on your model. Can make this with my fingers.
It's like an, a dry brush and some. And go in all the rivets. Of your model. Wolves. And now I think you can see the these things popping up. It's one of the things I love to make on my models. And with a more diluate, you can make on all these round things, okay? I don't like to paint a model only in one color. For me, it's not the way I like to work. Okay. Can put here on these edges. You see it? Okay. Now I can remove almost everything and pass on this. Let me put some more ink on this and be very careful. You will see on photos on my Facebook and you will understand what I am doing. And because I put the return, I can pass with my finger and it makes a difference. Here? No, I need not because I'm going to paint this in brown. Okay, this is a wood box. So now let's go to this rivets. Okay. Here on the fender. Okay, I think you can't see it. Now here we got some in this. This is like painting. Okay. Now let's go and here too. Don't forget, when you're working later with the oils, this is all going too dark, okay? Now I can apply with the brush. A little water, okay. fingers, make like this, and it's going to fade color, and try to remove that hard lines. Okay. If you know something about watercolor, it's the same technique, using water to remove the hard lines. Okay. As you can see. So now let's continue on the rivets. It's just like you make with your dry brush, okay, technique, okay, it's just like that. Now you're on the fender too. Okay, so let it dry a little and then pass with my fingers. Here, you can see it. Now, these things here go light. Okay. Now here on the back, let's make all these rivets here very light. Okay. I'm doing this, but don't forget, do the, I put the filters, then I will go and make the pin washes. The pin washes I will go and make on all these rivets too. So it's that why you don't worry, because these are very bright, okay? My real purpose of this is to make this bright. And then you will see on the weathering, okay, that things will show through. Okay. So now, I'm sorry, King, about the sound, but I am working with my head down, and it's not easy to speak for the micro. Here you can make these edges okay too, with the very light movements of your brush. Okay. Here no, because it's a dark side, because of that box. You're on the fenders too. You can see it's like you are shaping all your model, and you can see right there. It's, I think it's beautiful. Okay.
But it's my way. There is some steps. I do. Okay. And all my models. Okay. Let me put this like this and work on the side too. Yeah, make like this, don't on the top. Okay, you see something like in there. And when I going to dry brush with the gun metal, this parts I am making this, it's going to be very, very nice. Yes, you can make some lines. I'm sorry. Pass your finger, it helps to blend. Don't make a all complete line, okay? And because I am using the retarder, it's helped me when I put the paint not to dry, and I can work with that. Okay, just more strong. Okay, and yes, here you got this thing. Okay, nice. You let me make a little line there. Okay, as you can see, I am correcting now this part. I don't like too much. The good thing, you can put your water. Don't go with thinner, guys. Mark there, okay. Sometimes it's not the things we want, so no problem. Okay, there I'm going to make some different. So now let's go to the turret, and the same thing, the same process, okay. These things all highlighted, okay. Here on the top, not on the backside. Here the same thing, okay. A line there, okay. Okay, to have some providence there. The rivets, okay. Yeah,
here.
Okay, I'm painting
for the top, see it in all angle if that's what you like it, okay? Go quickly. Okay, and it's going too dry. Clear. Okay. Okie dokie. Almost. No. Some lines here, okay, not very crazy. See this panel? Very, very gentle. Don't have any problems with this. Okay. And you can see you start seeing the difference of the panels, that little all things there, okay? And see? With your finger make this and make that good highlight there. Sometimes we must go with a brush to make some different shapes and things, okay? Okay, with the model. Yeah, I done everything. Let me see, I don't see nothing to escape. This is going to be painted, no worries. Just a little there. And yeah, it's making this with your fingers to fade and have that color. And when you're making the weathering, it helps a lot, this fading color. Okay, so as you can see, not very difficult to do this. We got to have only patience to make this. I'm making these more lines here. These lines are very good for your eyes to see it, okay? And I see it. I like this. So sorry guys about the noise, but now it's time to make that mist, okay, on my model with this from the mythical, so the 19, okay, this one. So let's shake it real nice. Thank you to have you here, Kim. And I am already most done with this. So, like I said, now the transpirator. Okay, 9 drops of this. Oh, let me put just one of these. No, that is not, because I'm going to make a mist. Okay. And let me see. I'm going to show you. In this white spot, it's very transparent. Okay, the color you see on the white and the black, it's very transparent. This. So, let's make that mist. On the model. First I go in the turret. Okay, done. Now here. Let me put this away. Needs just a little more. Sometimes you want to go with 2 or 3 coats. For me, I just want 1. Because I am making weathering, okay, filters, pin washes, all that stuff, and it's going to dark all the model. You see, I almost cracked that thing there, okay? And this is going to the first step to unify all the things on the model, okay? That's the thing why I put this rivets so much bright color, okay. And now you can see all the lights through the model. You see, it's
different. I go there and correct missing this. There in the panel. Sometimes you do not to paint the model all again because one mistake. Okay, you can correct always the mistakes. Don't worry. Okay. I'm not going more on that. Let me see again this. Okay. And now the wheels. The wheels have parts of the model. And we want the same thing. Just a little mist. Okay, and you see the difference. We are not going to need much of this. Can see is this is begin to unify all colors. Okay, you see the difference. You see the most shadow in outside of the rims, and to the inside it's begin to more brighter, and it's done this color modulation. I know lots of guys don't use a thing like this, but the brands have these. The Vallejo have, I think Tamiya have too. I don't know, but I only like to paint with acrylics now. And that's the way I want to go. Sorry guys, I must clean this. Let me go with this. This is very important. To clean your airbrush if you want to make a good paint job, your things must be clean, guys. Like I do with my brushes, I clean all and then I put in my mouth to make this point a real nice point. Okay, so guys, as you can see, the color modulation, it's all done. The only thing I must paint, it's the tracks. Okay, I think it's not good to show you on this. And there is another thing to paint. Okay, let me go to the box of the model. And these parts. Okay, this I will glue later, and then I will paint with my brush. Okay, because I want to paint this all back, and I don't like to paint this on the sprue and then cut and then go with the pencil. I go with the pencil, I'm going. Maybe
with the green base, okay? And you will see in the photos it stay right good, okay? So guys, I hope you like it. Any questions you have, you can go on my Facebook channel, on my YouTube channel, and make all the questions. If I make any mistake, don't have any problem to talk with me, because we are always learning every day, okay? This painting modulation for the green vehicles, it's like this, but if you can see, in the with a tank or vehicle with camouflage, we can do that color modulation, okay? I will do next month on the Tiger I have to build. I have an Academy Tiger to build, and maybe on the BPM 3, BMP 3 I have of the Russian army, I will make the camouflage, and I will show with this stuff, I don't know you know, how to make the camouflage with this, you can see here, and how I made the color modulation on the camouflage too, okay? It's more difficult. But like I said, there is nothing we can do, okay? We can do everything if you want, okay? You just got to try it and make it, and you'll go, okay? So guys, I hope you like, and I see you tomorrow with the color modulation of a desert vehicle with the M2 Bradley from Academy, okay? So guys, see you tomorrow, and very thank you to watch. See you tomorrow with the color modulation of a desert vehicle with the M2 Bradley from Academy, okay? So guys, see you tomorrow.